Have you ever played the what if game before? Like, what if I didn't take this job? Or what if I did take this job? What if I dated that person? Or what if I did this event instead of playing that sport? What if, what if, what if? Have you ever played that before? I know I have numerous times, and I think you're not alone if you've played this game. You know, in fact, it's kind of funny. Right now, Marvel and Disney are doing this What If series about their famous superheroes. And what if this happened to Iron Man? Or what if this happened to another person instead? And how would life have played out that way? Again, I think we do that all the time. And again, if you've done that and you've questioned the decisions you've made and the actions you've taken, you're not alone here. By the way, everyone, I'm Tom Pounder, and I'm the online campus pastor here at New Life Christian Church. And the cool thing about the what if game is that there's lots of examples of people asking this question, and there's lots of examples of that found in the Bible. And we're going to look at one particular situation involving a guy named Moses and the what if questions he asked of God and how God met him where he's at. So we're going to look real quick at a situation found in Exodus chapter 3. But before we do that, I want to give you a little bit of background about who Moses is and who he is at this moment and when we meet him in this story. See, Moses was born an Israelite, a Jewish person. And at the time of his birth, the Pharaoh, the ruler of all of Egypt, was killing all the male babies because at this time, Egypt had enslaved Israel, and the Egyptian Pharaoh was afraid that if there were too many people in the Israelites, that they would one day overthrow the Egyptians. So he decided to start killing all the male babies. Well, the mom, who was an Israelite, said she didn't want that to happen. So she gave birth and then gently pushed Moses down the stream in a basket. And in this basket came upon the Pharaoh's daughter, and the Pharaoh's daughter adopted him as if he was her own, and he was raised up as an Egyptian. Well, one day as he was older, Moses came in an encounter with an Egyptian guy ruling over some Israelites and whipping them and beating them, and he didn't like that. And so Moses fought him and then ended up killing that man and then leaving, running away from Egypt, running away because of the fear of the consequences of his actions and that would take. So a shameful, alone Moses wandered and wandered, and he came upon this family, and he married a daughter. He became a shepherd. And so where we pick up the story is that Moses is a shepherd, and he's looking over the flock right now. So we're going to pick up right now at Exodus chapter 3, starting at the second verse. Here's what it says. There was an angel of the Lord appeared to him in flames of fire from within the bush. And Moses saw it, so through the bush, was on fire, but it did not burn up. So Moses thought, I will go over to see the strange sight, and why does the bush not burn up? When the Lord saw that he had gone over the bush, God called to him within the bush, Moses, Moses. And Moses said, here I am. Wouldn't you be kind of freaked out if you were in that situation? I know I would be, a bush calling out to me. But Moses said, here I am. Do not come any closer, God said. Take off your sandals, for the place that you're standing is holy ground. And then he said, I am the Lord of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. At this, Moses hid his face because he was afraid to look at God. And the Lord said to him, I have indeed seen the misery of my people in Egypt. I've heard them crying out because of their slave drivers, and I'm concerned about their suffering. So I have come down to rescue them from the hand of the Egyptians and to bring them out of the land into the land filled with milk and honey, the home of the Canaanites, Hittites, Amorites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites. Sorry, I'm not exactly the best about pronouncing some older names. But and then he says, and the cry of the Israelites have reached me, and I've seen the way the Egyptians are oppressing them. So now go, I am sending you, Moses, to Pharaoh to bring my people out of out of Egypt. So God gives Moses this amazing opportunity. He said, I've heard the cry of my people. Now go, I want you to free them. And so this is a big task. I mean, if I was Moses, I'd be a little bit scared. And so Moses naturally had some questions. Okay, so let's see what Moses does in response to this. Let's pick up in the 11th verse. But Moses said to God, "Who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and bring the Israelites out of Egypt?" And God said, "I will be there with you, and this will be the sign to you that is I who have sent them. When you have brought the people out of Egypt, you will worship God and go to the mountains." But then Moses said this, "Suppose I go to the Israelites and say to them, 'The God of your fathers have sent me,' and they ask me, 'What is his name?' Then what should I tell them?" And God said, "I am who I am. This is what you should say to the Israelites. I am has sent me." And that's a really important phrase right there. I am who I am. But the bottom line is that Moses is having questions and he's asking what if questions. In fact, this one wasn't even enough to settle him. He asked two more questions following this that ultimately ended up frustrating God. But he said again, what if? What if they don't believe me? What if this doesn't work? What if this happens? And Moses was afraid. And I think when we look at it, you know, Moses was afraid, but we often are afraid. When God asks us to do something or when God encourages us to take a next step of faith, we get scared. It's hard sometimes to take a next step of faith because we think, well, what if I do this for God? What will these people think? Or what if I do this? What will happen here? We go into a bunch of what if scenarios and we ask, what if, what will happen? And the reality is that when we take that next step of faith, God is going to be there with us. I loved it what God said. He said, "I will be there with you. I will be there with you." You know, no matter what God asks you to do, the great thing about it is that God's going to be there with us and God's going to provide it for us. Moses ended up going to Egypt. Moses ended up helping the Israelites get out of Egypt and into the promised land. Moses was able to do that because God helped them. God asked them to take a next step of faith, and he did it. And God was there with him all along the way. And the book of Exodus is a fantastic book. If you've never read it in your Bible time, because it's a great story about how God was always there with them and rescued them out of slavery into the promised land. So I want to encourage you to think about this. When you have a next step of faith, and when you feel that nudge on your heart that God is asking you to do something, don't ask the what if questions. Act in faith, act in obedience, because knowing that God is there with you and God will guide you, and God's going to use you to impact not just your life, but the life of other people around you. So I want to encourage you, don't stress about the what if games. Trust Jesus, follow Jesus, and see where he leads you. Again, it's going to impact you and a ton of other people around you when we're obedient and trustworthy and faithful to God's calling in our lives. Well, I would love to hear your thoughts on this. I would love to hear what you're thinking. Definitely put it in the comment section below or go to tomp@newlife.church and send me a little email about your thoughts. I would love to see kind of what if questions you've asked in your life and how God has provided for you despite your fears, despite your uncertainty, and how God's been there with you and what blessing it has been for you. Again, when we trust Jesus and we take that next step of faith, God's going to provide in a big way, and he's going to be there with us and lead us to great things. So I want to encourage you to do that today. All right, everyone. Well, thanks so much for being a part of this devotional with me today. Let me pray, and then we'll wrap up our time. Dear Jesus, thank you so much for today. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for guiding us and directing us. Thank you for leading us. Lord, we trust you that when you ask us to do something, we can respond in faith and respond knowing that you will provide for us, you will guide us, and you will direct us in everything we do. So we ask for your provision, we ask for your guidance, we ask for your boldness, and that we can be obedient to your calling in our lives. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Thanks so much for being with me today. I hope you have a blessed day.